International city councillors and mayors aren't usually involved in the constitutional squabbling in Canada, but Cote Saint-Luc has done just that, got involved. On Monday, the city council there passed a resolution on Canadian unity, saying Cote Saint-Luc belongs within Quebec and within Canada. But that resolution leaves other cities wondering, just what does it mean? Paul Carvalho reports.
This is Cote Saint-Luc, Quebec, Canada. And that's not just a mailing address. These days, that's a political statement. Cote Saint-Luc's resolution says a breakup of Canada is unthinkable. The subject may be out of a city council's jurisdiction, but it just had to be addressed, says the councillor who came up with the resolution.
This is not necessarily our mandate to handle constitutional affairs, but it is our mandate to handle the well-being of our constituents. We have to speak up. We have to do something.
The resolution is a heartening reminder to the mostly Anglophone, staunchly Federalist people in the city who are now living through yet another chapter of the language conflict. But what the resolution doesn't say is whether Cote Saint-Luc remains in Canada or goes with Quebec in case of a breakup.
That's not the intent of that resolution, and it's not spelled out that way. This is a resolution to promote unity rather than to promote disunity.
But that's just the problem with the resolution as municipalities like Westmount see it. If the resolution went so far as to take a stand on partition, it would cause a furor. But by not addressing partition, it doesn't say very much.
This is truly a resolution that comes out of the closet and either says what it wants to say or it doesn't. And if it's just simply a mum's apple pie statement, I'm not interested.
And Mayor Trent wouldn't be interested in a more forthright resolution either, because he's against partition or any talk of it. Still, others like Cote Saint-Luc's declaration.
And I think it's an excellent initiative. It's worth pursuing, and it's worth better understanding. And it's worthwhile for the people of Cote Saint-Luc to maybe rally around it and express their collective opinion.
A stiffer resolution is likely to run into a wall of opposition in Cote Saint-Luc. For now, all the city is really saying is that it hopes it never comes down to a choice between Quebec and Canada. Paul Carvalho, CBC News, Cote Saint-Luc.